If we're going to do a rundown of some of the best role players in the league, one of the top names that surely pops into anyone's mind is Donte DiVincenzo. He recently signed a 4-year, $50 million deal with the Knicks. And I believe this is a match made in heaven, whichever way you look at it, because of his unique skill set on both ends and ability to shapeshift in any role that's assigned to him. With this said, let's take a look at why Donte DiVincenzo is such a perfect fit for the New York Knicks. DiVincenzo was a key guy in the Warriors' rotation last season, averaging 9.4 points, 4.5 assists, and 3.5 rebounds, while shooting 43.5% from the field and a career-best 39.7% from downtown. And during the 36 times that he played as part of the starting unit, his numbers were even better, especially in terms of points and rebounding. Those were solid numbers. But needless to say, his impact on both ends of the floor has been his biggest asset thus far, and one of the areas where he excelled last season was playmaking. Whenever he drives into the lane, he always looks to feed first instead of taking it on his own, and on several occasions, DiVincenzo showed his unselfishness by giving up a good shot and turning it into a great one. Check out this play right here. DiVincenzo attacks the baseline to force the defense to react. When he got shot down, he remained patient and didn't force the issue. Instead, he used that moment to survey the floor and locate the open guy, which was Jamichael Green in this instance. Now, in this pick and roll action, DiVincenzo quickly attacks the moment he loses his defender. When the help shows up, he quickly switches gears and drops a nice bounce pass to Looney as he rolls to the rim. In this give and go play, DiVincenzo could have taken a wide-open mid-range jumper right here, as AD didn't bother to step up. However, he passed on this opportunity and instead dished out a nice no-look dime to the cutting JP3 at the baseline. DiVincenzo passed on 66.5% of his drive attempts last season. That was the highest rate among the pool of 271 players with at least 100 total drives, and it's also the highest rate for a player with at least 200 total drives in the 10 seasons of tracking data. Now, when he's not setting up his teammates, DiVincenzo can sometimes take it upon himself and just score the ball directly. With the shot clock winding down, DiVincenzo has no time to do a drive and dish. And so, he just figured out a way to get the shot up by breaking down his man and laying it in. Anyways, his ability to create shots on his own didn't stop there, as he can also find other scoring avenues through off-ball movement. The Dubs were supposed to run a split action here, where DiVincenzo would curl above the screen set by JP3, which is why DiVincenzo's defender was already looking at his teammate, signaling to do a switch. However, DiVincenzo suddenly went backdoor to catch the defense on his heels, and with a clear runaway heading to the rim, he just took flight and put Eubanks in a body bag. But aside from these, his greatest weapon last season was his three-point shooting. As I mentioned earlier, DiVincenzo shot 40% from the arc, which is his career high, and along with that, he also made 153 pointers, while ranking fourth in three-point attempts and three-point made only behind Klay, Steph, and Jordan Poole. He was basically automatic from range last season, so much so that he was making tough running threes like this look so easy. Now, if the defense goes under the screen, just like what Clarkson did here, DiVincenzo will not hesitate to pull the trigger and make them pay. And since his confidence in taking three is so high right now, he can just take logo threes and bury them as if he was channeling his inner Steph Curry. Now that we're aware of what he's capable of offensively, let's now talk about what he can offer on the defensive side of the ball. DiVincenzo was tied for third when it comes to defensive rating last season with the Warriors, ranked third in defensive win shares behind Draymond Green and Kevin Looney, and was the Warriors' top guy when it comes to offensive fouls drawn. Listed at 6'4", DiVincenzo is a big two-way guard who loves to play the passing lanes and cause disruptions with his reach. At the same time, he has a knack for reading plays, which allows him to anticipate long passes on kickouts. Look at this play. As the Wizards locate Gafford on the elbow, look at how DiVincenzo positioned himself in between the corner and wing shooters. He gave a slight hint that he's going to cover the corner man, and so Gafford swung it to the wing instead. However, DiVincenzo played him like a fiddle as he read this one like a book, stole the ball, and just ran away with it on the other end. Now, in one-on-one situations, DiVincenzo also knows how to manipulate his matchup into taking the tougher route. Knowing that Ja can easily get past him, DiVincenzo makes him go left to where the help is, and after he feeds him to Looney, he recovers from behind to swat away Ja's attempt. DiVincenzo's two-way tendency is certainly going to make coach Tom Thibodeau smile from ear to ear next season, and one of the areas in which I think DiVincenzo can make a huge impact right away is in the shooting department. Though the Knicks had the third best defensive rating during the regular season, they were only ranked 19th in the NBA in terms of three-point percentage and 23rd overall in three-point attempt percentage. What's even worse is that their three-point percentage has plummeted to 29.2% in the playoffs, and this was easily one of the main reasons why they got booted out by Miami in the semis, 4-2. Both Julius Randle and Jalen Brunson were ranked in the top 15 of players drawing double teams. On the flip side, DiVincenzo shot 42.4% on catch-and-shoot situations from three, and with this said, he can play the role of a floor spacer who's lock and loaded every time and ready to knock down shots on kickouts. And if you take a closer look at his three-point efficiency, you can see that he shot above league average in every area beyond the three-point line, with the exception of the left wing, which means that the Knicks can locate DiVincenzo from almost anywhere around the arc, and he'll surely deliver in return. Now, aside from providing extra firepower from distance, DiVincenzo can also give the Knicks a huge boost when it comes to rebounding. Advanced stats show that DiVincenzo ranks in the top quarter in both offensive and defensive rebounding at his position. And even though he's not that tall, DiVincenzo always finds a way to give his team another crack at the basket through extra effort and hustle. Look at this play right here. The rest of the Warriors have already run down to the other side of the court after Jordan Poole missed the shot. Except for DiVincenzo. With Ingram not boxing out, DiVincenzo snatched the offensive board, dished out a sweet dime, and electrified the crowd in one single sequence. Again, after JP3 missed the shot, DiVincenzo flew out of nowhere to grab the board and gave JP3 another shot at the basket. DiVincenzo is a plug-and-play type of role player who can coexist with any player in any type of lineup combination because of his versatility and ability to quickly adapt on the fly. There's a bit of a logjam in New York's backcourt, and DiVincenzo will have to fight for minutes against Quickley, McBride, Brunson, and Grimes. But due to the fact that the Knicks and Thibodeau have personally handpicked him this offseason, I'm pretty sure that he'll be seeing somewhere around 25 to 27 minutes with his 3-and-D capability. And while we most likely be seeing DiVincenzo come off the bench and be part of the second unit, I'm really interested in how things will play out if he got inserted together with his fellow Wildcat alumni Jalen Brunson and Josh Hart in their small ball lineup. The addition of DiVincenzo to the Knicks has already addressed one of the prevailing issues that they had last season, which was the lack of outside shooting. Although he might not be the player that could solve all their problems, having a solid Swiss Army knife kind of role player like DiVincenzo is certainly a great first step towards what they're trying to build and improve on.